What's going on? How you doing? How you been? I ain't gonna stop, man. I got a little distracted watching one of my favorite streamers. Shout out to Chaos 101 Darkness. But what's going on, guys? How you doing? How you been? We got four real ones in the building. Then we good, clear to do this. Chef with the try hard one. And Chef, do you know what happens? Chef, hit the exclamation point charity so you could be given to them charities, Chef. With the Kriegasm one, the forehead one, the swift rage one. Chef, do you know what happens, Chef? When Lizard makes a call and Mark Andrews ain't never been booked in a match in 2 months, do you know what happens? There it go. I didn't say you needed to do 100, but not certainly 200, but thank you so much to the Murky Dungeon with the charity 100 and the charity 100 and the charity 100 and the charity 100. Could you just sit the bitch? Set out the Jet Setter with a charity one hashtag charity. Could you just sit the bitch? Oh yeah, could you download the updated Zatoichi? Hell yeah, that's why I'm making some space right now. If images are used, they won't be deleted. Alright, sound like a plan. Yo man, shout out to you guys, man. Hey, word up. Hey, I'm about to get the new Zatoichi, get the new Lizard. The new Lizard's about to take up Mark Andrews' spot on the roster. That's why I went ahead and deleted Mark Andrews. I think he was pretty much as a placeholder for Lizard until y'all got this thing rolling. The way y'all got this thing rolling, you know what I'm talking about? Fuck Andrews. Yeah, honestly, man, I kind of was looking forward to seeing what he could do maybe in the New Breed show, mostly because I ain't never seen his ass. Placeholder bitch. You terrible, Chef. You terrible. I think this is the new Zatoichi. But I know this is the new Lizard. Got 7 real ones in the building. Shout out to every last single one of you guys. Shout out to Two Belt, shout out to Trade, Chaos 101 Darkness. Wonder how many slots I got open now. Damn, Desperado been downloaded 4 times. That's what's up. Henny 5. Casey leading all day. Forgot to make Lizard 100. Alright. Well, make him 100 and re-upload him. Nah, I ain't gonna make you do all that. I'm maxing out right now, bro. I ain't tripping. I don't even know if I should max him out. You said this is a draft anyway, right? I ain't gonna lie, I wasn't even gonna pick him up until you no longer said he was a draft. Let me try to think though. If he a draft. I ain't worried about it. Sound like I just took a victory in Chaos 101 Darkness stream. Shout out to Trade. Give me the opportunity. I'm about to kick off a new Breeze show. We'll get Lizard a match. They had to get another phone. Shit, you doing better than me. I ain't getting no other phones. I promise your ass that. But what's going on, Kyrie? How you doing? How you been? All right. Here's hoping they got me on the right show. Yep, that's the right show. Let me see something. So I have three phones at my disposal. Alright, well, dispose them shits then, girl. Why don't you hand one down to me? The big homie. The big homie need a phone too, you know. Gosh. Kyrie, you just so great. Gotta have it all, huh, Kyrie? Gotta have it all, huh? About to put Chick up against Lizard. And a one-on-one ski. Oh, I'm glad it played just that part. Oh, that's lit. That's lit. Got all the calls. Start with the call, end with the call.
Thank you.
Got Lizard making his debut on the New Breed Show. Lizard over here looking sexy, looking colorful as usual. We might set social media on fire. It is already trending, ladies and gentlemen, on this Saturday afternoon. But how's y'all day going? That's all we trying to figure out is how's your day going? I'm about to have to get some of these in action. So let's start off with the best one. Maybe y'all learn a thing or two. Maybe y'all pick up some tactics.
Oh!
got GGs in the building. Shout out every last single one of you guys. Huge match. Huge victory. A rookie and a two-time Hall of Famer going one-on-one tonight. Blizzard over here picking up a sexy victory. Or did he? As the chick is gonna dance. And dance, chick, dance. So we got anybody else in the building who's not on a New Breed show? We got an ECW pay-per-view coming up later tonight. Shout out every last single one of you guys. Damn, motherfucking Trey about to have a Bullet Club Battle Royal. I see Chick, see 6ix9ine, Casey, Yasi, Zatoichi. I ain't even gonna stunt. I'm about to host that match. What show is Ichi on? You mean Zatoichi? I don't know. Is that how you pronounce his name? Damn, that should even go through. Alright, I'm about to double check the chat. Put whoever else in the building. Hey, what's going on, Saint? I ain't see you in the building, player. Saint, I'm gonna put you against Jet Setter in a one-on-one ski. Zatoichi. Zatoichi. I got you. Yeah, I ain't going nowhere though. Gotta get the Saint in action. Matter of fact, Saint, I ain't about to play you, put you on this early card. Saint, since you in the building, you see how sexy Casey got for the other show? Wearing them sunglasses and shit. Alright, Saint, we gonna get it right. Alright, so this the show. I don't even know if you're still in the building, Saint. I bet. You are still here. Saint, I'm about to set you in and do a running on Lil Kyrie. Because I could clearly see Lil Kyrie's in the other chat. I was waiting for you to come in the building so we could see what was going on. And I'm going to put the bullet, Saint. honestly. I don't even know if you got a rematch at Saving Alexander. Let me see which one of these I could bump. What I'm looking for is the number one contender for your tag titles, or the new breed tag titles, which used to be the Undisputed tag titles. This team's going to face off. This team's probably going to wind up forming, but they ain't going to make it all the way to you. The winner of this is going to face the winner of this, and the winner of that match is going to wind up taking on you and your tag team partner. But before that even happens, Saving Alexander has arrived in the Fight Club. What's going on, Jeff Setter? Jeff Setter, you ain't seen none of these plans. Saving Alexander is going to issue an open challenge to anybody on the New Breed show. Sink can answer that challenge. Let me get that match tonight. I just want to get this promo right here first. So I put this promo a little bit earlier. That way I can give you the match, like, after this one or something like that. Smell me? I ain't even about to restart the stream or nothing. I'm back. That's a title match Jason got. That's Chef and Zombie. I'm assuming Chef was already here. I'm assuming Zombie gonna be here. He always winds up sneaking up in the building. I'll likely answer when the pay-per-view. Anyone might take you up on that offer and work on Saint a little bit. Get all the advantages. Oh, you got the game? All right. Well, Saint, this is what I do want you to know. Casey's already booked you. We're doing three pay-per-views. Last night we did the final battle. The first Aleister Black earning number one contendership. The first Pretty Boy Sensation that got in the building got the match. Decker ass showed up. Goddamn. 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, right? Shout out to Decker. Right? He was talking about we need another Pretty Boy to come in here fast. But the Pretty Boy Sensations. Now I'm going to see if I can get the game while it's on sale. It's on sale right now? That's what's up. I wonder if that UFC shit back on sale. My whole chat just cleared for some reason. On my Xbox, the whole chat just cleared. The fuck was that about? But tonight is Catch Hell. I think John Bishop technically is booked for tonight, but if he don't wind up showing up and you do, we'll wind up putting you in that spot. That's how I'm doing y'all's championships. Whichever one of y'all show up for the title match is going to be the one who defends it. If y'all all here, y'all can decide amongst yourselves. With that being said, I think I can officially run this off. I think you said you weren't going with the title match tonight. Are you going to wait until after you get your updates? And that's fine. All right, well, that's what we're talking about. Let me get y'all both in a match. I ain't even going to make y'all do it backstage. You do a false count anywhere. I ain't going to stunt Jet Setter. I don't think Baron Corbin got a good chance of doing it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put his tag team partner in the match. And see how his tag team partner does against the Saint. And hope that works out for him. Yeah, Jet, I know. You want your superstar in action, but we're going to get your tag team partner. God damn it. That's your good brother now. You guys been tag team champions for 2 months. Y'all better act like y'all like each other. I looked at the game. The game said y'all ass was about to be in a rivalry. I said to myself, well, I'll be damned.
know it.
The ear rape. What's going on, Puck? How you doing? How you been? I can't complain at all, player. Especially now when we got one of the original baby makers in the building. One of the got the bullet saint in the building. Yeah, no bullshit. This week we seen Casey blew out his knee. So make sure you send Casey, if you didn't already know and you haven't already sent Casey some thoughts and prayers and all that good stuff, make sure you send it to him. He was training for a big tournament that he was supposed to have today and blew out his knee. Trained, I think, for what, 3 weeks, 3 months, he told me. The week of the tournament, blew the shit out. He's main evented, I think, the last three shows. He main evented Final Battle against Aleister Black. He main evented Ring of Honor against White Privilege. He main evented the House of Hardcore against Dean Ambrose, picking up victory after victory after victory. God damn it. John Bishop has got the pretty boy sensations looking as dominant as ever here in the Fight Club. Shout out to Decker. And there's his speed paying off. Oh boy, he is rolling.
Hard to argue your take on this match, Michael. When there are no rules to enforce, you boom! Here's his chance. And kicks out at two. Very nice.
You'd be surprised at what these superstars can do.
Jeff said, I think I am putting her on Xbox.
Look out, there he goes.
I think I am putting her on Xbox. Our Xbox women division needs her. And she's going to get a bigger push on the women's division. I mean on the Xbox. Because she's basically going to be one of three women we have so far in the women's division. Nice, and I'll send some wishes and show Dex some love when I see him. When can Randy get his rematch with Razor? Good question. Saint just waking up. Long, late night. All right. You want a rematch against Razor? Give me two matches. Give me two matches, and I'll get you that rematch with Razor. We got a deal? I need to goddamn post up this card for tonight. I'm about to post it. I ain't about to put no graphic together or nothing. I'm sorry. But this is definitely not a Ring of Honor. This is a pay-per-view. We hooked up for House of Hardcore. Jason came up with the name. The Fight Club came up with the matches. Supposed to be the Pretty Boy Sensation defending the House of Hardcore Elite Championship against Orton and Naito. Apollo Crews defending the IWGP Intercontinental Championship against the traitorous Kyle O'Reilly, the villainous Kyle O'Reilly, and Shane McMahon. Jericho defending the TV title against the Mysterious Benefactor. The House of Hardcore Women's Championship match has just changed. To Little Kairi versus Alexa Bliss. EC3 will be taking on Rey Mysterio Jr. in a rematch for the Best in the World Cup. The Guerrillas of Destiny tag team titles between the Strange Bedfellows and Beer Money. One half of the Strange Bedfellows here in action tonight. In the House of Hardcore Light Heavyweight Championship, Ryan Rex has an open challenge to anybody who has a House of Hardcore superstar in the building. Here he goes. Yeah, I think I'm about to post this shit. His shoulders are down. Let me save this one right here. Dug down deep and gets the shoulder up. How'd he do that? Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Here we go. Now, but he's got to capitalize now. Ooh, what impact. Can he finish the job?
This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six matches with a possible seventh. He's making a statement here with this attack. I think there's another title on that show that ain't been on the line in a minute. But we're going to see. Trying to turn this thing around.
Oh, nasty impact. Oh, boy, he is rolling. Now he's working that exploit.
Put an exclamation point on the end of a match, guys.
He finds himself in some big trouble here. There's a good chance he can't recover from this.
He's in tough shape, guys, and there's absolutely no room for error now.
Swinging neckbreaker connects. Setting him up right where he wants him.
Pulls the ripcord. Ooh, right to the face.
But I don't know how much gas he has. He goes for the cover. Two. A kick out, and he almost had him.
How did he do that?
We have seen him here before.
Alright, I'm about to post this shit right now. Making a few minor edits to that thing. And congratulations to Hito Kiri picking up a huge victory here tonight.
A legendary performance. I can watch highlights of that one all.
I'm about to post this shit in the Discord right now.
Great WWE matches I've ever been able to watch.
GG's. Never mind, I'll get the bad guy later since you have Orton scheduled. Well, we're doing two shows, but we're not doing both shows. Like, I'm doing two different streams. The stream later tonight, you got your title match for not Razor Ramon's belt. Tonight, Jason Davis is fighting for Razor Ramon's belt. Because he earned an opportunity at it. Shout out to Chef McTastic with the charity one. Charity one, 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 charity one. Kiki's in the building. Chef, could you just sit the bitch? Yeah, we got two cards. I'm about to post that shit in the discard. We about to get through this one right now, though. Let me see if I can sneak you into this match, Puck. I think since it's a title match, they won't let me sneak you in. And he's been on fire lately. So is the New Breed Show! Trade, how you doing? How you been, bruh? 16 real ones in the building is Angela Faith. Oh, ye of little faith. Is about to call somebody out to kick off the New Breed Show. What's going on, Two Belts? How you doing? How you been? Thanks to everybody who came along with the Chaos 101 Darkness Raid as we proceed to give you what you need. So, Trade, how's Wrestling Twitch treating? I hope it's been great. Hope you've been getting all the matches. You won't be winning all the matches you get. What you guys didn't see is the chick with a stick already competed in a dark match. Taking on Lizard. The Bullet Saint took on Hito Kiri, the Deadly Assassin. Puck Dad just rolled up in the building. Want to know what the hell is up with his title opportunity to rematch at the Bone Soldier Championship. Puck, I'm willing to make you a deal. Mostly because the Bone Soldier Championship, I'm trying to segue that belt firmly on this New Breed show. For some new talent here. Potentially some car talent here. So what I'm willing to offer you is yesterday you picked up a huge victory in a six-man elimination match. You got a rematch clause. You earned a number one contender at the House of Hardcore Elite Championship, their main title. And got a rematch clause at the Bone Soldier title. Puck, if for some reason you're not able to cash in this opportunity tonight for the Elite Championship, if you put the Bone Soldier title in the past, leave it on the new breed, and you proceed on how so hardcore. I'm willing to give you a shot. For winning that match yesterday, the IWGP Intercontinental Championship. For dropping the Bone Soldier rematch clause, I'm willing to honor that exact rematch clause on ECW Television Championship. Don't know. You'll take that? Alright. And I'm not saying they all happening tonight, but I know the World Heavyweight Championship one, the Elite Championship one is happening tonight. Choose option C. Just said I'm trying to figure out how you didn't. Oh, and look at little Kyrie. I'm trying to figure out how Jess Setter didn't invite Randy Orton to Money Incorporated. Puck Dad saying deal. I feel what you're doing. Hell yeah. I'm about to give Randy Orton his the proper push. I'm going there attacking everybody. I'll be honest with you guys. I like the way Randy Orton's been used since he's been on SmackDown. Period. Outside of them whack-ass House of Hardcore, House of Horror matches, and the weird WrestleMania match, I like that feud with Bray Wyatt. I like Orton joining the Wyatts. I don't like the way he left the Wyatts. But I like the way he goes in there and attacks everybody. Specifically all the faces. Well, what's funnier than that, Puck, is that before you had him, I don't think nobody ever consistently had him. Like, he's been picked probably two different times, three different times. I don't think they've ever gotten him in. Nobody who's ever had him, I don't think, got him in more than one or two matches, period. And I like what you do. Now everybody wants him. That's because you out here winning. So I'm just biding my time. That's what you need to do. You're doing it real right. As Angela Faith has been biding her time, challenging little Kyrie, let's have a match once and for all. Because I'm sick of you going around here collecting all these championships just like you got a bald head. And after I'm done with you, that's just what you're going to have, a bald head. Oh my God, and Angela is spitting the same kind of fire Chloe be spitting on this mic. Kyrie saying, you want everyone to think you're so big and tough, but deep down, I know you don't want to beat me. You want to be me. You even have my poster hung up in your dressing room. Oh, little Kyrie with the retort. Saying Angela is a huge fan, and she's not giving no autographs tonight. Angela represented by the iconic Paris. Lil Kyrie represented by Kyrie Bay, not Kyrie, with the new phone. Because I'm sick of you. I'm dying. Did I say that? I don't have to justify myself to you. I don't owe you an explanation. I got that poster to throw darts at, bitch. It's target practice. Kyrie saying, one way or another, you and I are going to have a match. It might not be today or tomorrow, but soon everyone here is tired of you running your mouth against the other superstars. You aren't better. You aren't more beautiful. You're trash. And I'm going to take pleasure in taking out the trash. What's going on, Fronto? How you doing? How you been? Best case scenario, you're going to get a match with me if you're lucky enough. And you'll lose. I just don't understand why you're so excited, so eager to be embarrassed in front of your precious new breed universe. Little Kyrie, without a doubt, has taken over the Fight Club, winning the ECW Women's Championship on a House of Hardcore show, holding firmly in her grasp the New Breed Women's Championship, as well as the Fight Club Hardcore Championship. Angela saying, there's been so much back and forth about whether or not we're going to fight that we missed something. I don't actually care. Maybe we'll fight at some point, but you lost my interest. You can't tell me that you're the best woman on this roster. Not while Angela's on it. And Angela strutting her stuff, walking off as the beautiful member of the Beauty Club. Just letting them know how she feels about him. What's going on, though, Fronto? How you doing? How you been? Yeah, I'm thinking you guys, mostly because I know you guys could be anywhere in the world. But the Ultimate Warrior, the Devil's favorite warrior, and the Bullet Circus, the Black Wolf Churches, Z is here with us, and we appreciate you. Chaos 101 Darkness saying, I'm backstage. Yeah, you better be backstage, because your ass booked in a match. And if you booked in a match and don't show up for it, your ass might get booked in a... Oh, whoa, with Lucille. Nah, that's going to be your only saving grace, Trey. Your only saving grace. What's going on, Paris? How you twerking? How you been? Paris, you just missed your girl Angela coming out here calling out little Kyrie. A lot of interesting developments. A lot of combustible elements. A lot of women on this show is looking to be the top girl. The HBIC. The head beauty in charge. Angela Faith definitely is calling her shot toward that. 143 comments, and in my native language that means I love you and I love every single one of you guys. Oh God, thank you guys so much. No, you guys could be anywhere. You guys could always been anywhere in the world, but you was here with us. We were for each other, and we appreciate it. I want to thank the Academy. I want to thank God. I want to thank my mama for cutting me out. Thank my daddy for stepping off, getting out the way. I want to thank Puck Dad for having a fucking great time all week. Gotta thank Chaos 101 Darkness, stepping out the darkness, stepping into the Fight Club. Gotta thank the Iconic Paris for being iconic. Gotta thank the Chess Center for for all the Jets sets and all the limousine rides. Alright. Goodness. This is so unexpected. So unexpected. Shout out to you guys. The exclamation point GF. That shit was funny as hell the other day. Somebody put up there the grandfather. I'm like, damn. I'm old. What's going on, Nick, with a whole bunch of numbers? Thank you so much, Nick, for having a whole bunch of numbers. If it wasn't for the bullet blitz and that whole bunch of numbers, where would we be? Want to thank Fronto for being a big baby balling out out here on these streets. Don't know. They say a lot about big babies. God damn it, they were talking about Glenn Davis the whole time. They had no idea that the big babies was balling out on the streets. They had no idea about the fracking. I want to thank Big Fronto for bringing awareness to fracking. Thank the Bullet Club Baker for bringing Starbucks to the projects. The Bullet Club bartender for keeping us drunk. Second Chance Girl for giving us a second chance. We wouldn't be here without that second chance, y'all. It's just too emotional. It's just too emotional. Oh, God. Oh, no. Shout out to you guys. What's going on, Chubbs? How you doing? How you be? I figured this one would be a good matchup. I know it's two monsters, but goddamn, Ultimate Warrior is a monster in his own right, and he has a monster with him. Old girl said it. Goddamn, Lil Z was motherfucking Captain Planet. I want to know what planet that motherfucking Captain Planet on. If he Captain Planet, the planet must be Apocalypse. You guys don't know what I'm talking about. If he Captain Planet, I don't even know what planet that would be. Got the ladies in the building, the iconic Paris. Miss Chubby and Too Sweet, Second Chance Girl. Saw I lost baby girl a bit earlier. Saw Not Kyrie a bit earlier. Not Kyrie, goddamn, hit me up in the DM talking shit first thing. AJ Styles is so damn OP in this game. Yeah, that was mad random, though. Appreciate your trade. Doing amazing. That's good to hear. Paris Chubby says she figured out how to make donuts yesterday. The glazed kind. You know I know Captain Planet. Yeah, but you know the Planet Apocalypse, though? Do you know the Planet Apocalypse? Planet Apocalypse is Darkseid's planet. He's got his whole run of the place. If that motherfucker right there is Captain Planet, he the Planet of Darkseid's planet. He the Captain Planet of Darkseid's motherfucking planet. Shit. Earth, wind, fire, water, heart. You ever had a little motherfucker, the last one with the heart? I was just eating donuts. And you didn't bring us none, huh? You see what I'm talking about, Chubbs? You see what I'm talking about, Chubbs? Paris didn't bring us a single donut. Got them two beautiful dogs and didn't get no donuts for none of us. Made sure to share every last single picture of the little beautiful dogs so we can get the virtual. But goddammit, ain't bring a single donut, and she know how much I love them telly donuts. Said sorry. You ain't sorry, Paris. Over here lying. Don't lie to me, girl. Cause you ate all the donuts last time, club. God damn it, just said it. Don't tell everybody. Don't tell everybody. Goodness Christ. You know how much juice it takes to get this hair loose. You don't know. Really not, though. Wait, really not what, though? Oh, you really not sorry? I know you ain't sorry, Paris. I know that you was enjoying them donuts. I know the first thing you gonna do is ask Chubby when she get them donuts, make sure you get one before Club gets to them. I know that's what's going down. I know that all you guys is gonna send Chubbs a whisper and make sure that all y'all get one before Club get one. So it's all good. But see, what y'all don't know is that me and Chubbs got something going on. Yeah, I said it. All the rumors is true. You guys thought it was all along, huh? Well, you was right all along. As me and Chubbs is going in a business together. Yeah, I said it. Yeah, I said it. For a chubby and too sweet bakery. Yeah, I said it. Yep, so that means I'm gonna get all the donuts I want. You guys gonna have to take my seconds. Whatever donuts I don't want, you guys can have. How about that, huh? Gonna keep all the donuts for me. God damn it. He used the glaze for his hair. His club secret. God damn it, Puck. You wasn't never supposed to come in my dressing room. I don't know why you're telling everybody. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be on PW Insider or TW Insider. Chubb's like, huh? Wait, Chubb, we not going into business together? It's not Chubb being too sweet? Alright. Well, I guess we not going into business, y'all. I guess y'all is going to get all the donuts you want. Alright, and there's nothing I could do about it. The same way there's nothing Z and Lil Z could do about the fact that they want to maul the Outlaws Warriors menacingly. Wait a minute. Glaze hair gel? Girl, this ain't gel. This juice. This glaze hair juice. Alright? You ain't got the juice, Paris. You beautiful, but you ain't got the juice. Alright? And the juice is loose. I promise you. Billionaire baby doll, no. I don't put nothing but natural juices and berries in this hair. Gotta get my soul, keep my soul glowing. Fuck the scumbag who's selling my game early. May he be deleted, is what you saying? Fucking too sweet. Clever, I got you. Breaking news, Club used glazed donuts in his hair. This is not a pay-per-view. Oh, yeah, I gotta change the title. This ain't the pay-per-view. My bad, y'all. My bad. Had too much shit going on. Get this real right. Pay-per-view gonna be tonight. There's a championship for my title match here yet? Nick, that's going to be tonight, too. Damn, Nick on top of things. I ain't even post that shit yet. Well, I mean, I posted it earlier. Let me post it officially, though. In the Fight Club Authority room. See if we get this real right. Boom. Alright, it's officially posted. Trash Breed, You Imagine, Clever Die Bakery calling Pucking Too Sweet. I invading the WWE picture pay-per-view. Bitch, Saint, I coming. Saint is dead. What? What's up with all the Saint slander? Saint's not dead. Saint's not even Adam Cole dead. The Saints has a lucrative contract, all right, and has since he started here in the Fight Club. God damn it, Saints got one of the best deals here in the Fight Club. I ain't even gonna lie to y'all. Y'all don't even know. As the Saint has a Brock Lesnar deal on this motherfucker. Shout out to the Bullet Saint. Shout out to the Pretty Boy Sensations. He got that Brock Lesnar deal. I ain't even going to play around. Saint is on record saying that he is a lazy part-timer. And even when he's here, he's not necessarily trying to get booked.
nothing left to give here. Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this.
And why are you coming? I like to be alone, also not dead. There you go right there. In case he does too. Too bad at the pay-per-view they're losing. Fabulous Truth versus Maalisha. Is that tomorrow night? They're both, the winners of that are going to be 30 in the Royal Rumble. Paris, when you say should be, you mean should be the number 30 in the Rumble? This match is fucking awesome. Kane and Z.
Wow. Part of me thought that was
Kane setting them up. And the winner of this match will be taking on the winner of our other tag team match tonight for a number one contendership at the Saints Tag Team Championship. Call of Duty saying Paris, ew. Ultimate Warrior getting a better of Lil Z with a suplex and a beautiful one. And Kane's got Z getting ready to hoist his big ass up for a choke slam. And it's a 1, 2, 3. And congratulations to Outlaws Warriors. Close. The match should be happening tomorrow. Yeah, I think it is tomorrow at the TLC pay-per-view. You know something? I ain't gonna bullshit y'all. The Fabulous Truth is fucking great. As soon as they put them together, they was great. As soon as they started having R-Truth doing backstage segments with the women, it was great. Alright? I didn't know where it was leading up. I didn't know they was gonna team up. But I've always been a big proponent of Carmella. Carmella's dope. You're you, Call of Duty. Moose gets a t-shirt, Cannon shoots Kane in the nuts. Dance break! Farris just bossed up to the 84 in the chat. Yeah, but with all that being said, I'm going to say it like this. I hope the Fabulous Truth wins. But it's like all the rest of them tag teams in that Mixed Match Challenge, like the weird way they did the Mixed Match Challenge this time, where it was a round robin that turned into a tournament that boiled all the way down to this. It's like, which one of these teams was the same team that started off? That's what I'm trying to figure out, because I think the Fabulous Truth is like the only team that was the same team that started off. I know Kevin Owens had to be replaced. AJ Styles was replaced. Finn Balor was replaced. Braun Strowman was replaced. The main reason they do dance breaks is because when they did the dance breaks, the ratings skyrocketed. I fuck with the dance breaks. I fuck with the dance breaks. I don't think they should be, like, the coming out interrupting somebody for a dance break, I feel like you shouldn't do that every week. You should do that, like, in a big spot, like when it's going to actually really be advantageous for Carmella next week or R-Truth next week to interrupt somebody they could potentially wind up feuding with. But I do think they should have, like, Truth TV. And Rusev didn't dance, the ratings drop. I do think, like, Truth TV should, like, actually be featured on the show. That's what I'm saying. Like, and they should do the dance break in the middle of Truth TV. Should do Truth TV, like, every other week on that shit. And the weeks they not doing that shit, they should do Miz TV. But what do I know? I'm just one man. And Rusev should have did the goddamn dance with the Usos. I ain't gonna lie, that shit would have been lit. That shit would have been lit. Yeah, but I fuck with that shit, man. Carmella, R-Truth, I'm all with that. Just got word, Call of Duty. What's the word, Call of Duty? Let us know. And Saban Alexander's out here, ladies and gentlemen. The Elite. The Elite. Casey will lose at the pay-per-view. Cuddy, damn, you just negative, man. I thought I was negative. Farrah saying the reason they always dance break is for the ratings. Yeah, I'm with that. I'm with the dance break. I'm saying that they shouldn't just like the first time I seen R-Truth and them come out and interrupt somebody that was already doing something in the ring with the dance break, it was fire. But like this past week, they interrupted, I think, a tag team match. They wound up getting Jeff Hardy kicked in the back of the head by Shinsuke. And it's like, well, R-Truth wasn't intending for Jeff Hardy to get hit in the back of the head. So, like, why? Like, it would have made more sense if, like, I don't know, he did that to Jinder Mahal, especially considering he about to face Jinder Mahal. Something like that. Piss Jinder off because you're going to have to face him. You know what I'm saying? If I was them, I'd be on Mixed Match Challenge. But I haven't seen every episode of Mixed Match Challenge. So I don't know if they're interrupting Mahalisha every week. Because that would have been fire. Especially while Jinder was trying to take a second to do his motherfucking his chance in the ring. But this is what I'm saying. Like, I think that these dance breaks should happen during promos. And not like right before a match with four stars who all need the camera time, all need to get over. It's funny when Asuka started to dance. Hell yeah. That'd be the best part, when they get other women to dance. I mean, other people to dance with them. Like, I'm all in on the dance break. I just feel like they should do Truth TV and do the dance break in the middle of Truth TV. That way we don't actually expect it. So I'm hoping that this mixed match challenge winds up with R-Truth and Carmella not only winning, but them staying together afterwards. I prefer Impact. Well, now we all know what lies in store for us. Her uncoordinated ass and Saban Alexander issuing an open challenge to any one of you superstars on a New Breed show for the Elite Heavyweight Championship, ladies and gentlemen. Gotta let them know how you feel about them. Yeah, I wanted to see Rose Gold stay together too. I'm gonna be 100 with you. Rose Gold together in this stream. Goldust is definitely Mandy Rose's manager, mentor, and all that shit. What's going on, Kyrie? How you doing? How you been? Kyrie, what's the best mixed match challenge teams that the WWE has cooked up this year? I think Rose Gold was it. Like, I think Rose Gold versus Fabulous Truth is the way they should go. They'd have to put Goldust on SmackDown, though. And it'd be Goldust versus R-Truth. And they should do that shit just because of that reason. Shout out to Gabe 277. Thanks for the follow and welcome to the Fight Club on Club or Die on Twitch TV. Just sort of saying, I prefer Impact. I'm liking Dark Alley. Got some breakout talents. Looking for a number one contender at the Ladies Championship. Got Paris getting ready to set up in the ring. Got to put the ladies over. B&B. What's B&B? Oh, Bailey and Balor? I like AJ and Charlotte. Yeah, I like AJ and Charlotte. I like all of Charlotte's partners, except for Jeff Hardy. All her other partners were all in Fortune. It was like AJ and it was Bobby Roode and AJ. I'm like, all right, so are we getting the Four Horsemen? Like, are we going to get the Four Horsemen? Or are we going to get the Mixed Match Challenge Horsemen? No, I'm talking about, because I want the real Four Horsemen. I want Fortune in the WWE to be the Four Horsemen. That's why I fuck with the Undisputed Era, because they remind me of the Four Horsemen. They don't remind me of the Bullet Club. They remind me of the Four Horsemen. Real shit. They remind me of the Radicals more than they remind me of the Bullet Club. Revolution more than the Bullet Club. I think the WrestleMania Mixed Match Challenge match. I mean, the WrestleMania. Like I've realized when they did Cena and Nikki versus Miz and Maurice that they were going to do more mixed matches, and they should. If you watch old WWF shit when it was fire, like I watched a Raw the other day or some shit like that. It was like, it was going to be The Rock, Billy Gunn, and China against, I think, Right the Censors, Ivory, Godfather, and Val Venus. Bailey was in MMC. See him right now. It's B&B. Fuck Bobby. Her and Bobby were lit. Glorious Wu. Fuck you. Damn. All right. The Four Horsewomen of WWE versus Four Horsewomen UFC would have been great in Survivor Series. I agree because of the spectacle of it, but when I really think about that match, like, that's four of the best women in the WWE. All right? And they'll make anybody look great. But what we're talking about is four of the best women in the WWE, probably the four best women in the WWE. Taking on four WWE rookies. And that's essentially what it is. Like, I know that their MMA prowess speaks for itself, no matter what kind of training they got there. But we ain't talking about an MMA match. We talking about putting all four of them in a ring with the four best women. And I honestly feel like Shayna Baszler's gonna have the best showing out of all of them women. But Shayna should carry that match. Asuka and Miz are amazing. There's no hugging in wrestling. Miz is a legend. And here comes the billionaire baby doll, Abby S. Hush up, Kyrie. Hush up, Kyrie. Ronda's part of that four horsewoman? Yeah, I know. Shayna Baszler's better than Ronda Rousey in wrestling. At wrestling. You know it. I know it. We all know it. Really, club? I feel the love. Awesome. What's going on, Outlaw baby girl? How you doing? How you been? The Hall of Famer Outlaw wifey. Soon we do Xbox. My car will rule this. No. $1 million maybe doll. No, the billion dollar baby doll. No, Shayna's better in technical skills. Yeah, I know. She's also better, I don't know what the word is to describe what I'm talking about. So I'm going to call them intangibles. She's better at all the other things that you can't measure, but you can see them all. It's like her heel work is better than Ronda Rousey's face work, and it's easy to be a face. And then when it comes to the promos, I feel like Shayna Baszler does her promos in a very controlled way. I feel like Shayna Baszler's character really reminds me of Samoa Joe. Whereas Ronda Rousey's character is like, I don't even know. Every time she cuts a promo, she's like, everyone knows that women have to fight harder. And we're going to fight. And we're going to take what we want. And it's like, okay. I know what you're saying, though. She is a heel face. She's like an edgy, she's like a no-nonsense face. I get that. That's like Ishii. I get that. I've seen that a lot. I'm just saying, she's not. I don't know. It's weird, Paris. It's weird. It's weird because she shouldn't even be a face. And she slut-shamed Nikki. But who hasn't? Who hasn't? AJ Styles' best promo, she slut-shamed Nikki. Roddy Piper. No, it's not the same thing, though. Roddy Piper dropped pipe bombs like Punk and AJ Lee. Ronda Rousey is not nearly as good on the microphone as as Roddy Piper. And that's what I'm saying. Like, Shayna Baszler has full control over her her promos because she has a full grasp on her character. Ronda Rousey has like a lot of things going on. Degrading. AJ Lee was lit. AJ Lee was super lit. But that's because AJ Lee gets it. And that's what I'm saying. Like, when I say intangibles, I mean you get it. Like, you get what you are in the ring. You get what you are to the crowd. And you can play it no matter what you have to do in the ring. That's what I feel like Shayna Baszler has that. She already got it. And it's probably because they put her in a role that was possibly easier for her to grasp, which was the heel role. Top heel at that. That sexy transmitted promo was amazing. AJ Lee said all types of fire. Yeah, I know. AJ Lee's one of my favorite women in the world. And so is Outlaw's baby girl. And I ain't just talking about in the WWE. She an author. She got a movie about to be made about her. Or I mean, essentially, she do got a movie about to be made about her. She advocated to put Paige over in the WWE. And that's the reason why she in the movie. So, she is favorite wrestler, period. Was AJ heel at all like she wanted to be? But it didn't work. That's because she was too good at being heel. But she was heel. She turned on everybody. And did the angles where she slept around and shit like that. They don't even do angles like that no more. I guess. It's like when they do angles like that now, it's cringy. Like, I watched the angle where Terry Runnels, this is happening right before the Capital Carnage pay-per-view, where Terry Runnels had already been sleeping around on Gold Dust and was with Val Venus and then told Val Venus and the whole world that she was pregnant, and Val Venus said, "We're not pregnant. You're the one who's pregnant." And then said that he had a vasectomy, so he knew it wasn't his baby, I guess. And here comes the Scar Woman, and somebody just broke her out of jail. And I say all that to say this. What Terry did in that angle, she wound up forming the Pretty Mean Sisters with Jacqueline, who was also having issues with Mark Merrill. That was a sleeping around. What's that? See them arms behind her back? She used to being locked up, and now she's out here, and she's on the loose. And Scar Woman, Scarlet. All right, Outlaw, you saying you streaming tonight? When I said all that to say this, that was the storyline that they did that involved women and men, and they took it a bit far, and that was the attitude era. The AJ Lee one, I know they had her looking like a hoe, unfortunately, but she killed them roles. And they culminated in her getting a general manager position on Monday Night Raw. I think she was the first woman to ever GM Monday Night Raw. I know Stephanie GM SmackDown previously to that, but I'm pretty sure AJ Lee was the first woman to GM Raw. She got all that by virtue of her mic skills. I think they see a lot of that in Alexa Bliss right now. Shout out to Bianca Belair. I love Bianca Belair as well. She was a heel that was loved too much to be booed. Whose call is that, Scarlett? Broncos fan. Yeah, AJ was the first GM of Raw female-wise. What's going on, Phoenix Rising? Coming here with the fact-checking. How you doing? How you being, Phoenix Rising? 300 comments in the building. Outlaw's wifey streaming tonight. I'm on my own now. Yeah, I love AJ Lee, though. She's definitely a top girl. Kiss Hornswoggle, Dolph, Punk, and Daniel. I'm doing okay. Can't complain. Club, you tuning in? Fuck yeah. What time now? That's why I was asking you what time earlier. Bianca theme, man. Paris kissed Kane and John Cena too. Yeah, she said John. Gotta get these two women an entrance, as it's the Bullet Babe, Amber O'Neil, and our own Bullet Babe, Amber Fire. About seven? Alright. Sarah Bianca reminds me of Naomi. Not me. Not me. I think Bianca is a purebred stud. Or Amber, no title. They don't need a title. This is the number one contendership for the Fight Club Tag Team Championships right here. Don't forget about Brie. I forgot. Oh, she kissed Brie too? Forgot about Kane. I didn't even know she kissed Kane. That wasn't a good way to go. I'll try out law for sure if I'm not on too. I know, right? I think I might be on by that. I might not be on by that. Who knows? Gotta get this new Breeze show popping, though. Shout out to every last single one of you guys. Although you had a match, Kane and Ultimate Warrior had a tag team match against Z and Lil Z. Looking to get a number one contendership at a tag team championships here on this show. But AJ Lee's one of my favorite. Only reason I remember is because the whole John Cena, CM, Kane, Daniel were all about the same time she was flirting with all of them. As the new Breeze Show champion, can you let Stream know about my streams? Outlaw's wifey. Yeah, club, I told her they won. Oh, okay. Outlaw's wifey not only got Outlaw's Warriors, but Outlaw's wifey also got pictures of Scott Steiner for us, Jack Swagger for us, D'Lo Brown, Hardcore Holly for us. Works for the indie promotion and will be streaming live tonight. Gonna have Drago. And Drago to House of Hardcore. Are you asking everybody? If you go to House of Hardcore. Hey, what's going on, Easy? How you doing? How you been, Z? Easy, who'd you pick up? Tyler Breeze, right? I mean, Tyler Die Dillinger. If you see me online, just remind me. I can't complain at all, Easy. What about you, player? All right, so what was we trying to bring up in women for? The Mixed Match Challenge? I think CM Punk and AJ Lee should compete in the Mixed Match Challenge. I like to see Punk and AJ Lee together in the ring. Club, you said you were going to be on tonight for House of Hardcore? Hell yeah. House of Hardcore pay-per-view tonight, TLC pay-per-view tomorrow night. Club, you want... Hell yeah, Allo. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, Outlaw. You know I appreciate it. I'm working on the last ones you sent us right now. Did I lose my new breed title? I'm not gonna just take it from you. Not like that, though.
This is not where she wants to be. This is not at all where she hoped to be at this point in the match. These women are so evenly matched right now, guys. I can feel it. Here she comes on the counter. We'll see if she can turn things around.
I'm watching this on the stream. I need a Brett pick, Outlaw's wifey. Brett. I don't think Brett gonna be there. Tomorrow's my B-Day. Happy birthday, Outlaw. And everybody, make sure you keep the Outlaw in your thoughts and prayers. I believe you got an MRI. Make sure you keep Heartbreak Casey in your thoughts and prayers. I think he got an MRI, too. That is the champ. And the best man in the Fight Club. Casey being the first. Outlaw being the latter. I know that Outlaw is the best man in the Fight Club because Outlaw's wifey has made no bones about the fact that she is married to the best man in the Fight Club. She's married to the Outlaw. Fuck, sorry, we don't have one. Outlaw, you hooking up them brownies, though? You gotta tell me if you making them brownies, Outlaw. I want a brownie. Or one of them Outlaw cookies. Yeah, she's talking about her promotion. Always in forever? Hell yeah. Hell yeah, always and forever with them brownies and them cookies. I know that's what you was talking about. You gonna always and forever hook me up with some cookies and brownies. I don't need them donuts. Y'all can keep them chubby and too sweet donuts from me. Y'all know I ate up all of them the last time Outlaw got me. Got Phoenix Rising in the building. Club get a donuts to me then? You gotta ask Chelsea for the donuts. They told me they was gonna make sure I didn't get no donuts. Paris talking about she gonna make sure I don't get no donuts. Chubbs talking about she gonna make sure everybody get the donuts first. Jess said us making sure he gonna give out all the donuts before I even get them. Do a final roll call right before he asked me if I want some, and ain't even gonna be nothing left. Just so it won't be none left. God damn it, Jess Setter. I thought we left our rivalry in the past, Jess Setter. Don't you start it up with me over these donuts, Jess Setter. Don't ever come between me and these donuts, Jess Setter. All right, Outlaw, I'm coming. I'm coming. You guys can keep those donuts. I'm getting some of the Outlaw's wifey snacks. She got the bomb snacks. Bianca Belair with a 1-2. All right, so we on the record saying Fabulous Truth is a great mixed team, intergender team. Yeah, no Angela can face me. Can't just put her on me. All right, I won't put her on you. All right, you ain't got to take on Angela. Nah, you ain't got to take on Angela. But Kyrie, I got more friends than just Angela. I got friends in high places. I got friends in low places. You know what I'm talking about, Kyrie? I keep trying to tell you, you barking up the wrong trees. Ruffling a lot of feathers going after all them championships. Number one contender for the Fight Club Ladies Tag Team Championships on the line here tonight. Bayley and Balor. Yeah, but you just said that they weren't together, and I know that I've seen them in a promo together. Nah, I'll face Angela. Outlaw might fight you for my cookies. Oh, okay. Well, I'm not about to fight the Outlaw for them cookies. I'll take the brownies. Outlaw can have the cookies. I don't mind sharing. I'll take some Outlaw's brownies. And Nick with a whole bunch of numbers in the building. And he's on the New Breed Show representing Bret Hart. I'm about to step out of the universe in a second. Outlaw might fight you for my peanut butter cookies. Ah, you got them peanut butter cookies. Scar woman fresh out of that jail prison jumpsuit. In a submission match. Bork, bork. Bianca Belair with a 3 count, eliminating Naomi.
She counters before it's too late. She dodges that.
Amber O'Neil showing that savvy veteran presence. But it may not be enough on Bianca Belair, as Amber O'Neil is by herself. And it's a one, two, sweet.
She kicked out there, but I don't know how much more she can take. We're looking at complete domination here.
Because that's fair. How's that fair, though?
Look out.
Bianca Belair missing wildly. Amber O'Neil doesn't have much time to finish this here match. Finish off both of these women. Yep. Natalya ain't got too long before she loses superstars, though. I shouldn't even said that, though. Outlaw, when's your next event? Amber O'Neil taking out the referee.
One of the great WWE matches I've ever been able to watch.
Hope everybody got GG's. Can Angela kick Kyrie ass right now? Kyrie's got a match right now. Kyrie's got a match. She's already booked on this card. Where the hell's Scar Woman at? And it's all. Oh, there goes Scar Woman. And the new number one contenders. I'm about to screenshot that shit. Y'all bear with me just a second. Don't care if she can fight me if she has all them titles. January 26, 2019. All right. Y'all got Impact coming. Who is it? Moose, Eddie Edwards, Eli Drake, and Sammy Callahan. Well, not Kyrie. Just came here and took them all. Hell no. If I traveled, I'd so come to y'all shows. Phoenix, if I really had a way to transport you, I'd take you up there. Alright, I'm about to check, see who we got in the chat real quick. I know these ladies want to be in action. All right. Yeah, man. Shout out to Two Belts. Shout out to Not Kyrie. Supercard Pete. Pug Dad, Phoenix Rising, Nick with a whole bunch of numbers. Got Big Fronto in the building. Big Fronto, what did we say about CM Punk? You said you're dropping Punk, right? I forget who you were picking somebody else up or not. My bad. Already seen Outlaw in action. Phoenix Rising got a male and female superstar. He had two belts in action. He just didn't see it. So I think I'm about to want to put in a... Nick, which one of your superstars you want in action? Angela versus Kyrie submission match. I'll face Angela in a submission match for the New Breed Show title. We got Rich Swann. 26. Alright. I'm going to start planning for that. You know it's hard for me to make commitments about traveling. Mostly because we ain't got no money. Yeah, I did it. Yeah, I did it. Can we have your sexy man in action? Little Kyrie working her way up to this submission championship against Becky Lynch. For the New Breed Goddess Championship. Lil Kyrie representing the Bullet Shield all of a sudden. Bravo, Uniform, Lima, Lima, Echo, Tango, Sierra, Hotel, India, Echo, Lima, Delta, Bullet Shield. Shout out to all you ladies. Alright, so who else did I say we got in the building? Let me see something. We got Pug Dad, Phoenix Rising, Nick with a whole bunch of numbers. Big Fronto. Think about it, I have a fatal four-way. But Nick, which one of your superstars do you want in action? And Phoenix Teen, what's going on, Phoenix Teen? How you doing? How you, Phoenix Bean? With a cheer, one 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 cheer, one. Phoenix Teen, could you just sit the bitch?
Here we go, guys. It's now time for the submission match.
Look at sexy ass Angela. Faith. What's going on, Phoenix Team? Appreciate the bits. Appreciate the cheers. Ball Man is amazing. Oh, yeah. Let me go get Ball Man. You got a goddamn point, girl. No, Kyrie. No, I'm about to be late. Lil Kyrie, know I'm about to be late. Damn, this ain't the track. This Decker. It's that Decker work. And you get that Fronto work. Bah! Nope. It's late, Kyrie. It's late. It's just guys, late. Kyrie, I'm sorry.
Ready to square off here.
I know.
And there's nothing quite like seeing two superstars settling it in the ring in one-on-one action, Michael.
Hell no, I'm not rating the app. Get the goddamn shit moving. God. Gotta get little Kyrie's theme song popping. Gmail got a mind of his own. Alright, I got you, Kyrie.
Introducing the challenger from Colorado Springs, Colorado, Angela. Introducing the champion from Osaka, Japan. She is the classic global champion, Little Bad Kari.
That had us a week on the road.
This has all the makings of a legendary night.
Kyrie representing the Bullet Click in a big way, in a big bold way. Cause it's Big Baby Bowl Out. Appreciate it. But all credit goes to Casey. Casey, the one who made that championship. The one who made that championship. But Kyrie's the one who making it famous.
Like a bomb, yeah.
Recently worked on both of these ladies' movesets. I ain't even gonna stunt. Talking about it, I'm really more eager to see this match because of that. And Angela, what a beautifier! And a leg scissor. Trying to choke the life out of little Kyrie. And she's dancing, doing a dance break right now. I think Angela's having a good damn time in this ring. Knocking Kyrie down on a mat. Flat as a pancake. Some may say. Oh my God, and it's boss time! It's Sasha Banks! Sasha using her black magic to come down here ringside, ladies and gentlemen, here tonight. Can't believe it. Well, believe it, ladies and gentlemen. Because when I tell you it's boss time, it's boss time. S-game, shoot the motor spot.
High-risk maneuver that works from that top turnbuckle.
Angela on the top rope. Flying crossbody. All right, I'm back in the chat. Got 11 real ones in the building, but just hit 420 comments. Which one y'all think I care more about? Angela lifting her back up for another one, making Kyrie look beautiful. And here comes another leg scissor. I wonder why she keep going for this. I definitely gave her something else.
Look at this. She lets her out. She better have a good reason for this, Cole, because she just had her seconds away from tapping. She's countering nicely now. Yeah, a second ago, she was almost done. You can see the confidence just beaming from her right now. She's able to get out of the way there. She is on fire. Oh, and she gets out of the way.
The comments? What's the comments? Oh, let me go check them. All right, hold on.
Reverses that one.
After watching Lil Kyrie defeat Brazilian Honey, I will never count her out again. Kyrie Miss Rosanna, number one. Give her a fight. He's good, Outlaw's wifey saying. Thanks for asking. I mean, he's good, Puck saying to Outlaw's wifey. Rosanna, number two. I like her, though. LOL. Look who's here. What's going on, Decker? How you doing? How you been? That was kind of funny how Sasha just floated to the ring. Great match. Wow. Hell yes, but I wanted to put it on. I think both of these women was going to give it all. Kyrie off the top rope with a frog splash, and I think she hit the knees. Angela with a sidestep with Kyrie, a couple of kicks from Kyrie. Angela with a slap, and a disrespect is apparent tonight. Angela on the other side of the ropes. Got a little tangled up and confused, maybe. Little Kyrie taking advantage of the confusion. Put Angela position in a compromising position. Angela to get in control once again, though. And there goes that drop kick she was looking for. Finally dialed it up, ladies and gentlemen. And Angela is working that submission. And I think this could be it. Working on little Kyrie's small body. And little Kyrie look like he's in danger. Little Kyrie's in danger. The new breed champions. And somehow managed to get out. Angela sizing her up once again. Sasha ain't going to do nothing. I don't know. It's far from over. But a beautifier. God damn. Hoisting up little Kyrie. And another big one. Followed by this leg scissor, and she's loving this leg scissor. I don't even know if she can tap her out with a leg scissor. And there little Kyrie goes reversing it. Little Kyrie setting her up for a long suplex. Little Kyrie going to the top rope. Little Kyrie with a frog splash and meets the knees once again. Little Kyrie sidestepping the grapple. Angela reversing the hold. Angela setting her up for what is this, the fourth or fifth? Beautifier. And there goes that leg scissor for about the fourth or fifth time as well. And congratulations to your winner and new
show. Here's another gander. I can watch highlights of that one all night long.
And a huge matchup. An even bigger victory.
I don't like to throw around a lot of praise, but my eyes tell me that might have been one of the great matches in recent WWE history.
Here is your winner.
I'm about to take a screenshot of that one. I think we got a fatal four-way coming up. It's featuring a couple of real ones in the building. Puck, which one of your superstars do you want in action? Then we're going to go ahead and throw Brett in action. Defending home turf on a New Breed show. Got to get R-Truth in the match for Big Fronto. Abby just needs a title. And now look where she is now, still champ. PS4 out the closet. One time only for now. Shout out to you, Decker. Got key keys all around the building. One time only, most likely I'm online. Look who's here. Boys, we about to get the Pretty Boy Sensations on commentary? Is that what y'all telling me? Is that what's happening? I know that's not what's happening. All right, so let me get this real right. I know we got to put one of Puck's superstars, Phoenix Rising, in the match. And Decker in the match. Let me see if there's anybody else I'm skipping. I think everybody else has had a match. Got three of the Pretty Boy Sensations in the ring. I mean, in the building. You might want to read what Not Kyrie is asking for. I can invoke my rematch clause when I want. I get to pick the match this time. Maybe an I Quit match. Four tables. Randy? All right. Damn, I don't know, man. I kind of want to put the Pretty Boy Sensations against all you motherfuckers. I think that wound up classifying as a 3-on-3. I think that's what we're going to do. Talking about strange bedfellows. Pretty Boy Sensations is going to defend home court in the arena that Casey May fights. I already told you, I'll take on the whole damn roster. Yeah, well, now you ain't gonna have to do it all by yourself, Decker. Goodness. Beauty Club versus Pretty Ugly Sensations. Oh my God. That's fucked up. That's fucked up. Alright, so two belts. Which one of your superstars you want? The Velveteen Dream? Or the chick with the stick? Decker, I'm assuming you got John Bishop, but one night only. You're definitely going to be using him tonight. We ain't going to talk about your other superstar. Not after the way he went one-on-one. Greetings and salutations. What's going on, Joe? How you doing? How you been? I'm a pretty good heel. Yeah, I'll give you that. I'll give you that all day. All right, got to get the chicken action. Gonna make sure we get the Saint up here. Then we can fit everybody in this match though. Got Brett. I'm about to get R-Truth. I saw the way Bishop destroyed Black. Hey, I know it, right? The win-win situation, though. And Randy Orton. The three most dangerous letters in professional wrestling. John Bishop looking to take on all comers. A saint and a chick not looking at all. Who's the ugly tributes? Summer Rae, Chubby Bunny, the Pretty Ugly Sensations. Sola Have Adam is in this same faction. Sola Have Adam is in that faction. Not to be overlooked. Sola Have Adam has the same contract as the Bullet Saint. Paris, why you got beef with Summer Rae and Chubby Bunny? Why you got beef with Summer Rae and Chubby Bunny? Mrs. Belt says she's rooting for Chick. Shout out to Mrs. Belt. What's going on, Mrs. Belt? How you doing? How you been? Two Belts, put her on the phone. What's going on, Mrs. Belt? We done had two belts in the building. Goddamn. Stinking up the joint. You know what I'm talking about. He been playing practical jokes on everybody for the last 3 days, Mrs. Belts, and can't nobody seem to stop him. But we need your help, Mrs. Belts. We need your help. As the Smexy, John Bishop and the Saint make their way here tonight. Because Summer Rae's on their team. Oh! Paris got a lot of heat. A lot of heat. Got that right. And here comes the Hall of Fame champions. The New Breed Tag Team champions. The Bishop and the Saint. Pretty pink. Baby blue, why don't you teach me something new? She says hi, and she will try. Out here looking smexy for the first time on the New Breed Show in months. It definitely hasn't been since 2002 like Brock Lesnar. So I don't want to hear nothing about the Bullet Saints contract, ladies and gentlemen, as we proceed to give you what you need. And not like most girls. Miss Belt, how you doing? How you been, girl? Miss Belt, you've been... Two Belts told us you've been slaving over a hot stove for his ass all day. Miss Belt, what you hooking up for Two Belts? And you know how I love to eat, so what you got over there? Do you know I'm hungry? All right, I just ate. I ain't hungry. I'm just greedy. Do you know I'm greedy? This ain't nothing new. It's been good. May Southern Fro. Shit. Can my baby get a match? Nothing for me. Just said that you stay out of this. You stay out of this, all right? Me and Two Belts and Mrs. Belts got a love thing going on, all right? Yeah, we do. Yeah, said it. You just ate 24 donuts. You know damn well I didn't eat no 24 donuts, Jet Setter. You wouldn't let me have the 24 donuts. Shout out to Two Belts with the host. Club don't lie, you got Outlaw's cookies. Hell yeah, I stole some of them cookies. Had to take some of them peanut butter ones before Outlaw could get here to fight me for them. Yep, I told y'all by hook or by crook. I'm going to get some of Mrs. Belt's Southern Fried Chicken. I'm going to get some of Chubby and Two Sweets donuts. I'm going to get some of Outlaw's cookies and brownies, even the peanut butter ones. Yep, I'm even eating right now. Got yogurt, covered raisins. No, you can't have none. Nope. I'll share with you, Saint. I'll share with you too, Decker. You too, Two Belts. Ms. Belts, yeah, you can have some. Yep. Wherever Casey's at, I'm going to send him a care package with about 1,000 of them bitches. Some sweet, tasty. What did I just say? Raisins? What is this shit? Yeah, yogurt covered raisins. You know, you're more than welcome. We even have, I got barbecue sauce with the purple K. And Club, don't forget about that Chicago pizza pie you eating now. Come if you ain't get the cookies. I need to get up in the car right now. I'm about to get in the car right now. Speaking of deep dish, I got some in the fridge. Oh, Saint. That granddaddy. Okay, Miss Bell's trying to get Club. Fly, Robin, fly. Trying to get Club to be about as lit as a firefly, and I ain't mad at that. You know what I'm talking about? Club, stay hungry. You got to. I don't want nobody to ever say, Club, whenever you be rapping, you don't sound hungry no more. How? I'm always hungry. It's just like the Incredible Hulk and his secret. He's always angry, I'm always hangry. Every time I tell y'all I'm incensed, I'm enraged. All you gotta do is give me a Snicker bar, I'll probably be okay. I ain't gonna lie about it.
Everyone who competes as part of a six-man team has the ability to do that. We've seen many times over the years that a superstar's inability to do that has cost their team the match. We've also seen over the years that not all superstars play well roles. Some competitors are so dedicated to singles careers that when they are put in a six-man team, they become a dead man.
I could cross the bridge right now, Outlaw, if I wasn't tired as hell. I don't think you're going to be near Outlaw, though. I think she's further up in Pennsylvania. Let me get a bottle of that, though. Yeah, I put a whole bud. Oh. God. God damn. Club is a hungry for my chicken Alfredo. Where you at? I'm on the way. Club is the bottomless pit. You got that right. I'll finish it all. I'm the strongest finisher in the game. I want two bottles of that. All I cook is pizza, wings, and pasta. All right, Kyrie. Kyrie, where my invitation at? Talking all this shit, Kyrie, about my native language? He ain't sent me an invite yet. Terrible. Ask two belts, I made it for him. Yeah, he close enough to get it, though, man. Shout out to the Bullet Saint. Saint over here talking about he got slices of pizza and shit. I'm hungry, Saint. I want a slice of pizza. That ain't no goddamn pizza. For everybody who's never been to Chicago, that shit Saint talking about ain't no pizza, y'all. It's a goddamn pizza cake, okay? It's got probably three layers of toppings, cheese. Goddamn shit bigger than the biggest last two slices of cake y'all had to eat. Put them together. All right. I got me some sad-ass Domino's pizza over here, but I'm about to get it popping. I'm about to do all the things I learned in Chicago. I'm putting on all the toppings. All right, you know what I'm talking about? I got chicken. I got pepperoni. They turkey pepperoni. It's still good. You guys don't know. You guys don't know. I got some onions and peppers. I'm putting that on there. I got some extra mozzarella cheese. I'm going to put that on there. And then I'll put some more toppings on there. And then I'll put some more cheese on that motherfucking sandwich. Goddamn, as we proceed to give you what you need. Y'all hungry as hell now, ain't y'all? Club get peach schnapps? All right, I got you. Randy said, get your ass up, Bishop. I want goat cheese pizza that weighs a ton with chicken. I know it, right? Isn't that the one I ordered? Or the one I was asking about? I know it had chicken in it. I don't eat shit else. Club, I want peach schnapps. I'll get you some peach snapple. Hell no, I ain't drinking. Yeah, it is. Well, at least I ain't getting no goddamn onions and anchovies on that bitch. God damn it. I could have went way harder. I just wanted some extra cheese and some fried chicken on the bitch. I didn't know it was going to come out like that. You know what I'm talking about? I didn't know it was going to be like that. That shit tasted like lasagna in a cake. Some chicken lasagna and a cake. I ain't lying. These people don't know if they ain't never been to Chicago. Like, what the fuck does that mean, two belts? What do you mean it's red on the top? Ah, when that shit came, I knew what he meant. God damn it, I ain't got a dish that's deep enough. We going back over there soon, and it was awesome. Four Club had to take it back to his hostel with him. Hell yeah, I did. Anchovies is life, though. Oh, my God, Saint. What the hell have you been doing in Antarctica? I assume that this is because you have a lot more class than I do, Saint. With that fortress of solitude you have in Antarctica, I'm pretty sure all you do eat there is the anchovies and the finest of Bouvard caviar. On your pizza. Specifically imported from your favorite place in Chicago. Probably the same place me and Tubelts are talking about right now. My alt has nearly 30 hours. Your alt is your main account. What the fuck is you talking about? This is your alt. What are you talking about, Kyrie? This is your second account. Club is like that fat kid on Willy Wonka. I'm also like that fat kid in the 50 Cent video. I love you like a fat kid love cake. I'm also that fat kid off of Boys in the Hood who grew up to be Ice Cube. I'm not Ice Cube, but I'm the fat kid who grew up to be Ice Cube. Oh, you is talking about that account with the 28.9 hours. Shout out to you, Kyrie. Yeah, Kyrie, you're a real one. I ain't even mad at you. I ain't gonna lie to you though, Kyrie. Your name has definitely come up in a lot of circles, a lot of conversations. No, Kyrie, don't gamble at all. Oh, you went all in and won? Mr. Phelps, now I want to go to that pizza place Friday.
Nice.
He's like Matilda. Damn, Matilda was eating like that? Two Belts just ranked up. Got 203 hours in the building. Shout out to you, Two Belts. Got the Saint in the ring putting in work. Clubber Die leveled up earlier. Did you? Let me go back and check it. Let me see if I can go back and check it. If it's still up there. I wish that shit had the sound. Like they got on goddamn. Yeah, that was a terrible rendition of it. On Mario, when you get one of them mushrooms, start to really big ball it. Shout out to Aura Ramirez. Forever, never seems so long until it's gone. Shout out to Aura Ramirez forever. Shout out to Swagholic. Now bounce. Got Jess said, and Mrs. Belts is in the building. That's Mr. Two Belts Firefly. And the Pretty Boy Sensations is about ready to send Randy Orton somewhere to feel unpretty too. Ooh, ooh. Getting ready to take him. I got you, Two Belts. I got you, Two Belts. Yeah, I ain't gonna stunt. I know how to make that leaderboard work. But with all that being said, I think the Beauty Club's theme song should be that TLC Unpretty song. And with that being said,
Kurt Angle in May of 2017, the WWE Universe saw a dream team come together when the Hardy Boys joined forces with the Lunatic Fringe.
I got Two Belts song. And with the Pretty Boy Sensations in the ring, I want to tell you about something else.
If you've ever been to Disneyland, you know the lines can be real long. But I got a ride that the bitches love, and you won't have to wait at all. All you gotta do is ditch your boyfriend and give sexy Michael Starr a call. I'll take your ass for a weenie ride, spread your cheeks and swallow your pride. It will stretch you out so wide. I'm gonna take your ass for a weenie ride. Hold on tight, cause I'm coming inside. It's better than a Ferris wheel or a water slide. It's a weenie ride. I wanna swing about a thing that's funner than a swing and better than the market bar. On the couch or your water bed or in the back of your daddy's car, and it's open all day, nighttime too, 7 fucking days a week. It only shuts down intermittently so I can take a leak.
And I'll officially call this triple power bomb the weenie ride.
Down on your side, you'll be amazed what you can fit in there. Where some leverage is applied, open your legs for weenie ride. You won't be the first to see it and cry. Just bring the baby wipes and some astral blast. We'll be right back.
The Saint trying to save the chick and was not there in time as Bret the Hitman Hart has a submission. The sharpshooter locked in on the chick with the stick. And these two Hall of Famers are doing it. Real, real right tonight. Have a good one. Thank you so much for swinging through. Thank you even more for keeping an eye on Two Belts. Mostly because we know you could be anywhere in the world. Chick and Randy going at it. One-on-one. Chick giving Randy such a hard time, though. I don't think Randy Orton's going to be able to get the job done out here tonight. Not taking on a pretty boy sensation. Setting up for Bret Hart. And I said it before, this is a Hall of Fame matchup. Bret Hart and a Chick in two times. Bret Hart hopefully is going to be in two times by virtue of the Hart Foundation. And Bret sizing the Chick up. Missing for the first time. Connecting the second one for the sharpshooter. This could be a dangerous time to implement that sharpshooter in the middle of the ring. And the Chick taps out. And the Saint's up next. Saint with a good kick.
She don't want me locked up. Mama, I'm gon' wash up. With my wrist locked up. All my time is rocked up. I don't wanna sign up. Mama love me so I can do no wrong. Mama in a trap, so this her favorite song. I'm gon' get them racks, though, baby, they so long. Said I wasn't nothing, but I came in strong. You got the best advice, but I won't call. I know I'm grown, so I do not need y'all. I got it. And if I get locked up, I'll chase the law. Oh, yeah. You fix everything.
What's going on, zombie? How you doing? How you beat?
Even though I'm daddy, but she still gon' wear my balls. Don't care about this money, don't care about no cars. Lose my mama, that's a problem you can't stop. Mama, I don't wanna sign up. No way. I'm checking incomers. Like my dad, I'm a grinder. She don't want me locked up. Mama, I'm gon' wash up. Yeah, with my wrist in lock up. Yeah, all my diamonds rocked up. Oh yeah, I don't wanna sign up. Now I got the game in a headlock. Never catch me lacking, run with red lights. Bitch, we talking cool.
Got Brett with a bulldog. And Brett's taking over this matchup. I didn't even see what happened to the Saint. But I got all faith in John Bishop as John Bishop has decided to take on the whole roster. Not even if he has to. He wants to. Grana. Nick with a whole bunch of numbers got Brett and the Bliss Heart Foundation with Buddy Murphy. Oh, it was a tap out? The Saint tapped out? Are you fucking kidding me? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? The Saint tapped out? Since when? I gotta check and see if Vince McMahon was ringside and called for the bell. Two tap outs on the Pretty Boy Sensations. Might have to check Bret Hart's trunks or his boots or something for a foreign object. I don't think I saw the referee check in the beginning of this match. Since 2 seconds ago. Sharpshooter. Yeah, that was Vince McMahon. That was Vince McMahon. He's got a track record of those sharpshooters. But with all that being said, how much money y'all want to put on it that John Bishop is about to win this match? Let me see how much money I got. It's a lot of dollars. John Bishop taps one out. I put all my dollars on the line against any of you guys. He had a sharpshooter applied. Yeah, he had Vince McMahon ringside. Is that what you said? Club Truth or Dare? Truth. I put all my dollars on the line. I'll match any of y'all's bets. I don't care how much money you got. I'll match anybody's bet that John Bishop will win this match. When you lose the bets, you're going to be broke. All right, Puck, you taking the bet? I'll cover that. I'll cover that. John Bishop loses this match. I'll cover that. What should I do? Should I double it or should I give you the whole thing? If you're the only one who put the bet up, I'll do the whole thing. You get the whole thing. I think you're the only one with enough balls to go up against John Bishop. You got a dog in the fight, too. R-Truth going for the 1, 2, 3. I think that sealed it. All right, little Kyrie wanted to put that bet on the line. Damn, how many of y'all? Are you all right? You ain't got no money. What's the bet name? It ain't no live bet in the chat. I think he will. God damn it. I thought he would. All right. Hold on. See how much of this I'm about to give Puck.
Some superstars doing what they do best. Here are the highlights. Hope everybody at home set those DVRs because that was a match you're going to want to watch.
Yeah, I bit the dust. And again and again. Let's go. Rocks burning down the street. Ooh, and I look. Ain't no sound but the sound of speech. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? I don't wait to pull it. Yes, to the sound of the beat, yeah. There's great, and then there's another one bites the dust. WWE action. Ladies and gentlemen, another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey, I'm gonna get to two. Another one bites the dust.
Bye.
All right, I think y'all can go check now. We got 800 comments, 15 real ones in the building. Shout out every last single one of you guys. About to jump back in the universe. I'm about to put the momentum on this match on fast. Yeah, but Puck and Kyrie, y'all should be able to check. And Bret Hart defending home turf, the New Breed Show. And 2 weeks ago, Orton and R-Truth both were likely to wind up on this New Breed Show. Both wind up on separate shows. What happened to all your dollars? What, you gambled them all away? Kyrie, I gave all your dollars to your other account. The dollars that I just owed you, I gave them to your other account, your main account. Respiratory. Damn, Puck.
Yeah. I'm like, hey, what's up, hello? Sent your pretty ass soon as you came in the door. I just wanna chill, got a sack for us to roll. Married to the money, introduced her to my stove. Showed her how to whip it, now she remixing my low. She my track queen, let her hit the bando. We be counting up, watch how far them bands go. We just set it go, talking about to Lambos. I'm 56 a grand, come on.
What's going on, good brother 2K? How you doing? How you been, bruh? Good brother 2K, where the hell you been at, man? How many solo wins did you get? Hope it's been great. Hope you've been getting all the matches you want. Hope you've been winning all the matches you get. Got good brother 2K in the building. All right, Phoenix, have a good one, player.
Into the collar and elbow tie up, only one competitor.
Phoenix, enjoy the rest of your day. Mostly because I know you could have been anywhere in the world. But you've been here with us, and we appreciate it. Puck Dad saying, nice cause. That's actually some teamwork. Looking into colleges? That's what I'm talking about, 2K. That's what I'm talking about, man. I can't complain at all. Newport. Wow, somebody trying to get a smoke? Hell no, you can't have a smoke. Can't none of you have a smoke. Goodness, this shit'll kill you. Yeah, I can't complain at all. Just been having Newports, 2K. I'm stunting. I don't even fuck with Newports. But word up, man. I had a draft. Here on the stream, things have been going crazy. Whose cause? The first two are Chaos 101 Darkness and Angel Dust / Crown Royal. The second two belong as a total team effort. The call is technically Solar Boy Django's call. He's got one move set from Joe, one move set from X-Dog. And they're here tonight in the Fight Club. I hooked them up with the tag team gimmick and entrance. So when I say it's a total team effort, it's a total team effort. As they were not intended to be two superstars. Heard Jeff Cobb is Ring of Honor's next big thing? Yeah, Jeff Cobb's already their television champion. I know you Talia. That's not Talia's name, though. If it is, you gotta put the at.
Tell what his game plan was heading into this match, but whatever it was, it definitely hasn't been working.
Appreciate it, player. Yeah, they're running a storyline currently, and I figure it's about time we start progressing that storyline. It's a tag team. Is this what they sampled? Pretty excited for AEW. Word up. I heard they're doing an announcement in January. Big announcement about the promotion, about the company. But what you been watching though, player? I'm all into MLW right now. Good brother 2K. I love MLW. I'm all into MLW. WWE's barely watchable. Even this week's NXT kind of didn't have me really interested. I'm glad Tyler Breeze was on there. We got an update from Phoenix Rising saying that Tyler Breeze confirmed that he's going to NXT. So shout out to Phoenix Rising for dropping the deets, the details. Outlaw's Baby Girl promotion is about to have Impact Superstars at it. January 29th, I believe, including Rich Swann. Shout out to Rich Swann. I'm trying to think what else, though. New Japan's been doing shit. Wrestle Kingdom's right around the corner.
At this point, he has to be thinking to himself, what do I have to do to get back in this thing?
I didn't see Ring of Honor Final Battle pay-per-view. I'm probably going to watch that as soon as we wrap this stream up, as soon as we wrap up this show, as soon as we wrap up this Elimination First Blood match between the Darkness and the Solo Boys. As soon as I finish sweeping up this kitchen. Yeah, 2K, everybody's saying that, they're so excited about the Royal Rumble because they think the Elite's showing up, but it's like, I don't know, because they definitely got a new t-shirt deal going on, and they talking about an announcement, and they got these trademarks, and I just don't see how that's going to show up at Royal Rumble. I know the WWE ain't about to give nobody no part-time deal. Not those guys. They not about to let them Brock Lesnar this shit. Not for Blossom and Wrestling promotion. Hell no. Nah. So I'm not expecting them at all at the Royal Rumble. I'm expecting Shawn Michaels at the Royal Rumble. With all the WWE has shown the propensity to do for the past few months is bring old guys back. I ain't gonna lie. Of course I'm expecting some NXT call-ups. Send them to 205 after. You stress me out. You kill me. You drag me down. You fuck me up. I hate it. I love it. I don't know how to make it stop. Okay. He just had a match for the belt, NXT. Yeah, no, I saw that. It was kind of eh. Wonder what WWE talent is switching over to AEW. You know who I think it is. Get out from the stream account that the two of them could revitalize 205 Live and make it an A show. But it should never happen. And it should never happen because Tyler Breeze, in my opinion, can do a lot more on the main roster by himself right now. He's going to wind up doing it on NXT with any luck. The problem, though, is really not a... where he fits on the main roster. The problem is where the writers is going to put him. And congratulations, Trey, as the Solo Boys have had a little bit of trouble here tonight. I ain't gonna play that for Joe. I'm gonna play this for Joe. But good brother 2K. I was about to ask you, what do I call you? I just called it to you. That's who I think is going to AEW. Without a shadow of a doubt. I think Goldust is going too. And I hope they bring as many motherfuckers over there with them that they can. I don't care who it is. I don't care who it is. I'm trying to think of some obscure WWE talent. And spent 2 days? You got to do my time. 2 days is what, 48 hours?
Yeah.
No, I didn't hear that. What'd they say? What'd he get fired for? That ain't right. Right round? They asking Flo Rida questions?
You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge.
Yeah, but what I've heard is that their contract isn't up to the end of the year, end of next year. But with that being said, I don't think that the multitude of what we're seeing right now, by virtue of the trademark and the announcement, is going to really pop off until then any fucking way. But the bad guy's saying, cut the music. Okay. I have to wait another second to confront my demons. I just might snap. Let me clarify that for a moment. These demons aren't within me. I mean, sure, I've got problems in my head, but no. These demons I'm confronting tonight are much more vile. They're much more prettier. I'm tired of sitting here watching these superstars flap their giant gums about me while I say nothing about it. I had to sit through it at the Hall of Fame. I've had to sit through it in the retirement home. And I've had to watch it, not for weeks, but for months. Watching them run roughshod all over wrestling Twitch, all over the stream. John Bishop, quit acting like a little bitch and come out here and face me like a man. You beat white privilege, but you ain't beat the leader of the firing squad. One-on-one in this ring right now, tonight, in front of all these people, I'm calling you out. And the bad guy is calling out Ryan Rex, and these battle scars is something that Joe K. Green knows a whole lot about. Looking to snipe John Bishop from skyrocketing to the top of the Fight Club, both Hall of Famers. John Bishop, by virtue of his pretty boy sensationship. Yeah, sensationship. That's a word. That's the relationship between the pretty boy sensations. Keep up. All right. Now, with that being said, it's looking like John Bishop is grabbing a microphone. Silence. You people need to understand there's a time and a place to be raucous, but this ain't that moment. I've got to come out here and address a concern I have with this gentleman in the ring, so I'd appreciate if you all sat in your seats and remained quiet so I can give this man a verbal tongue lashing he deserves. Oh, God. John Bishop, the bad guy, face to face. I don't know what could have made you think that it'd be a good idea to come out here and piss me off. Why would you walk into the den of the biggest bear in the forest and poke it with a stick? It was beyond me. So I suggest you justify your existence to me before I put a swift and severe end to it now. And speaking of sticks, how's that stick going that you're sticking with the chick? Well, you know what? Do you really want to do this? Do you really want to provoke me? Trust me when I tell you, if you push me over the edge, it'll be the last thing, the last stupid mistake you ever make. Ladies and gentlemen, John Bishop, the bad guy. I don't know what could have gotten to these guys, as I think tempers are flaring once again here tonight. The bad guy saying, I'm going to share something private with all of you. This morning I woke up in the worst morning breath I've ever had. I think garlic breath and coffee breath mixed with something I didn't quite finish chewing last night. It was gross. I almost threw up. But I'd rather have that every morning than have another helping of John Bishop and those pretty boy sensations. We're the firing squad. And we firing on all cylinders. Well, you know, I'm going to make you my pet project, bad guy. I see something of myself in you. I really do. But at the same time, I feel like I failed you. I've let you convince yourself that you're the man around here. I did nothing to separate you from that notion, and that's on me. But it's my responsibility here on the New Breed Show, our show, to show Casey May famous. Well, you know what? I hear you, but I don't have time to educate you on the ins and outs of this business. The bottom line is, what you're doing here is not going to work. Your challenge is what we call in the business a hard pass. The bad guy, not one of mince words, is he? And a John Bishop with a kick to the bad guy. John Bishop with a float over DDT. And my God, ladies and gentlemen, in front of a sold out crowd. And I see John Bishop has no problem laying hands on the bad guy. John Bishop got problems of his own. Having an internal beef in the Pretty Boy Sensations with the Velveteen Dream. Check out what you guys been saying in the chat. As Kava Black takes on Lil Kyrie. Alright, 2K. He had a baby and wanted to go back home. Oh, damn. Who has all the women's championships? All right. Damn, I didn't even know that. In the middle of a push, too. What's going on, DJ Mac UK? How you doing, IUP? DJ Mac UK, man. How many hours you got in the stream, player? Shout out to DJ. Why the fuck that shit don't work? Why that shit don't work? I don't get it. Shout out to DJ Mac UK. That shit ain't telling me what I need to know, though. DJ Mac UK, hit exclamation point my time. I got 1429 in this mug. Appreciate it. Shot you puck that. Nah, no problem. Because everyone wants to see Kyrie versus Angela. We already saw that. What are you talking about? Now we get to see Kyva Black. Go one on one. For the sake of beer. Now just hit 1,420. 9.2 hours in the stream. Puck, I don't think DJ Mac streams. DJ Mac, do you stream? I was just saying, shout out to him, like, just, you know, like, shout out to him for coming through. If he streams, I definitely don't know about it. Like, my bad. I didn't know. We already seen Bishop versus Bad Guy. When the hell was Bishop versus Bad Guy? I do occasionally, mainly gonna be this game now. I've got it. Oh, bet. Okay, word. I didn't know. But little Kyrie knew. Little Kyrie knew. Oh man, hold on. That shit ain't responding. Lil Kyrie, it's always a problem with this song. Short of amazing. Oh my god. Moment, in fact, not when I hit so recover and that shit closed. God damn. Got Lee versus La Quinta tonight. La Quinta? Hold on, Lil Kyrie. Give me a minute. New Japan got two nights. The Elite's on this tour, or this part of the tour. Golden Lovers versus Tanahashi and Ospreay.
Both superstars coming to this matchup with a lot to prove.
Live at the cockpit.
Nailed it.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Bar wrestling, PCO, and cage. Oh, I'm watching that. We're all mad here. Oh, I'm watching that. All right, let me get my life right, right quick. Shout out to everybody rocking with us. I gotta get Lil Kyrie a contractually obligated, mandated theme song, whether it's on time or not. Angela had two matches. I ain't gonna let it go through without Kyrie getting to have two matches. I ain't even mad at it. They got an intense rivalry. They both doing what's best for business. Shout out to them. Shout out to Mrs. Belt. Shout out to Outlaw's baby girl. All the ladies in the Bullet Club. Second Chance Club. Lady Death. Shout out to all the real ones in the building representing for the ladies. Joe with the blueprint. Whoa. And ladies and gentlemen, it's Sola Have Adam. Sola's here tonight. And Kyrie down with a two count, and Sola making her presence felt. Not trying to be left out of the conversation. It's Sola Have Adam. Kava Black in the ring. Making a triumphant return here tonight, attacking Lil Kyrie, costing Lil Kyrie the matchup. Always interesting developments. Well, I just found it. What the fuck is solar? Solar panels? God damn, I'm terrified. You better be. You better be, Lil Kyrie. I told you was barking up the wrong tree. And you tapped your ass out.
Smoking tells you can't
I'm a smoky nigga, shut up to say hungry. I pull up under dress, spinning checks from the government. I'm sending hella bitches, shit on fuckers, that's just wanna flex. Full of shit, you ain't full of shit. Stop full clips of any bitch that pull up just this. Now who the fuck is this? Talking shit like they want some shit. I'm running to your bullets, little fool it with the money. And I mentioned most of them ain't in contention. Mm-hmm. It made no impression. You cannot reach this ascension. Mm-hmm. Don't know who you pressing. You do not know my intentions. Ain't plotting no vengeance, cause I will end it in another dimension. Time travel, nigga. I see the future, the past. I see a future.
Damn, that shit wasn't supposed to do that. That one was supposed to do that. Lil Kyrie saying, you did this, motherfucker. You did this. Who, Kyrie? Who did this?
Behind those words, guys.
Out here saying that he's gonna get right down to the bottom of it and not waste anybody's time calling out Daniel Morgan here tonight. Big mistake, still has a title on him. You motherfucker! They lost to Angela. Fair and Puck, shut up, fair and square. Ain't no one ass! Don't you tell the Godfather to shut up? Shut up! Who indeed? And you still lost, Kyrie! And that was BS, and I'm still champ. You still champ for what? Daniel Morgan, the Grim Reaper, saying, I liked you, I respected you, I would have helped you dodge a bullet. I mean, I definitely would have taken one for you, but that's still pretty good. Why are you starting problems? Ooh, Daniel Morgan out here all up in Tom's face. It don't look like it's time for love right now. Tom calling out Daniel Morgan saying, people around here are nothing but fools except you. You're the Grim Reaper. You have the talent and intelligence to realize this place is ours for the taking, which is why I want you to join forces so we can make our dreams come true as the Reaper. And Tom, gotta be strange bedfellows if the Grim Reaper don't like anybody. This company has been run so poorly. Wow. Okay, Cornelius 85. Thank you. With our powers combined, we are captain. I mean, we can right the ship. No individual, tag team, or group will stand in our way. We will rock the foundation of the Fight Club, starting here on a new breed show. And I think Tom is liking what he's hearing. You're damn right. You made a smart decision, bro. Forget what these people are telling you. They don't know crap. It's you and me. It's Tom and the Grim Reaper, Daniel Morgan, about to form an alliance here tonight on the New Breed Show. And gotta think with their similar haircuts. This might be a match made in heaven, ladies and gentlemen. What do you guys think? You better be sure about this, because if you try something funny, I'll destroy you. Today marks the dawn of a new age, because as a unit, no tag team in this company can defeat us. United, we will decimate and humiliate everyone who crosses our paths. Kyrie's backstage throwing shit off of the tables. Club, you still have the new Breed title and little car. Kyrie, she lost that to Angela. Bitch, no one asked. You tapped out. You tapped out. Okay. Happy bitch day.
On to the next singles match coming up next.
For the guys, yeah. You know, this one right here is for those that actually do not have time for a relationship. Don't just say that as an excuse.
Yo, light up.
Hey, you know what? It's for y'all too.
Now listen up, got no time for love. Shorty, that's a dub, that's a dub. Ain't no time for love. Shorty, let me shine, that's enough.
That's a what?
That's enough. That's enough. Yeah, that's enough. On my rhymes, bitches taking up my time. Yeah, I hear it all the time. They just swear to me like I'm not about to be another bitch. It's like another bitch. Yeah. I can be the one that dumb so fun that I swear all we gonna do is fuck it. Shit, I'm like, hey, that's the plan. Shorty, let me take your hand. You be taking off from work, I be taking off your pants. Then a week later, you in love with me. What the fuck did you discuss with me? I don't wanna be a dick about it, but we never gonna shop when it should have been a fucking spree.
No shopping.
Yeah, you got fucking needs. Get that shit, but it's up to me. I see the only thing you need is a towel for your fucking knees and like a cup of tea. And bitch, I never spoon. I ain't cutlery, so don't fuck with me. But you can fuck with me, but just fuck with me. Just fuck. That's it. That's really it. Now listen up. Got no time for love. Shorty, that's a dub. That's a dub. Ain't no time for love. Shorty, let me shine. That's enough.
That's a what?
That's enough. That's enough. Yeah, that's enough.
That's a dub, but that's enough. That's enough.
That's enough. That's enough. Now that's some motherfucking single for you, single kings. I don't feel a thing. I'm just here to smash. Hit it, then I dash. Where you at? 3 a.m. I want it now, and I don't wanna wait. Wait, we don't got a date. Pull up to your place. Let me say I gotta go. Say I gotta go. Tell her adios. Everybody know me. Yeah.
And his opponent, from Maryville, Quebec, Canada,
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the most must-see show on Twitch TV. Welcome to the Fight Club on Club or Die on Twitch TV. If this is your first time hearing this, what you're about to experience is something insane, as the show did not just start at all. Well, the stream didn't. Been on for 3 hours and 29 minutes. Wow. As we proceed to give you what you need, the New Breed Show. But the show don't officially start until you hear this sound right here. As we proceed to give you what you need.
Sometimes momentum has a way of permanently swinging one way. That's what he wants to avoid here.
Yeah, but if you count them out now, guys, you're making a very big mistake.
Got Kevin Owens trying to stave off elimination. Shout out to Zombie.
Kevin Owens setting it up.
Yep, Kyrie got some time. By my count, Kyrie got 16 days before the All Points Bulletin is put out. Before the investigation is officially launched. Curry, what stipulation you want on this rematch? What stipulation do you want on a rematch? Puck, Tupac cares, and don't nobody else cares. Hell nah, Kyrie. Kyrie, I feel like you told on yourself yesterday. I feel like you told on yourself yesterday. You know what I'm talking about, Kyrie. These people don't know what I'm talking about. They didn't have the exclusive backstage pass access. Malik had the backstage pass access, though. Yep. I'm on your heels, Kyrie. I'm on your heels. I shouldn't have said nothing. Let you think that you was playing their game. Oh, but what trouble we see with these tangled webs we weave. Ladies and gentlemen, as we proceed to give you what you need. Nah, Paris ain't Kyrie. I don't think Paris is Kyrie at all. Nah. Kyrie know what I'm talking about. Don't you, Kyrie? Don't you, Kyrie? I'm on your heels, Kyrie. I'm on your heels. Yep, I shouldn't have said nothing. Backstage bro, that's what you want to do with the title? Backstage bro? Alright, you do it.
He might have it.
The murky villains over here. Ming taking Kevin Owens to the top rope. Got Bullet Club shirts in the crowd and a suplex. Damn near sent Kevin Owens right into that crowd. In front of a raucous, sold-out crowd in Baltimore, Maryland.
There may be no coming back from this incredible beatdown.
A striking blow.
Whatever you say, Kyrie. Got Model Player 14 in the building. Lock Duck in the building.
You're not going to win.
Joe, which one of your superstars do you want in action? Joe, you're the only one who has not had a match. I'm going to put you in action next.
A quick reversal by Kevin Owens. Quick thinking to avoid that one.
We'll be taking on Pete Dunne now.
Take. I don't care how tough you are.
Oh boy, he is rolling. Oh boy, he is rolling.
He wants no.
What you mean? I ain't say shh. Too shh. Oh, I know what you're saying. Yep. Yep. Yes, I am. Yes, you are what? You late as fuck. I don't know what you're responding to, Kyrie.
He's looking at it.
I know you know what I'm talking about, though. Kevin Owens knows what I'm talking about. I like this one better.
He's playing with him now.
Welcome back, Chef. Hell yeah, you back in time. Randy will whoop Joe K. Green just to say it was a fluke. No title needed. I ain't gonna stop, Puck. I think we're gonna get Pete Dunne in action against Joe K. Green's bad guy. This game got a 1-3. And a super kick. And Ming is sizing up Kevin Owens. It's like you ring the chef bell. I have no titles. You don't need no titles, Joe. You got a title that can't be taken off of you. You are the bad guy. He's lean. He's mean.
I'll tell you what. This is one they'll be talking about tomorrow at work or school, that's for sure.
Too sweet him, ladies and gentlemen. Party! With the comments, 19 real ones in the building, and Kevin Owens just busted Ming open with that elbow.
Texas history making encounter.
I don't think the match gonna load up. What do I know though? I'm just one man, and that's just one man's opinion. And that is the main event though. We got anybody in the building who has not had a match? Then we're talking about getting Joe a match, taking on Pete Dunne. Fuck, I'm probably gonna make this a triple threat, throw your ass in it. It is a ladder match after all. Jason Davis ain't here to stop it. Poker Lady ain't in here to stop it, but I'm pretty sure that shit frozen, so we about to refresh for your main event. Hope to see y'all there in just a second as we proceed to give you what you need. Somebody hit exclamation point trivia. Got 18 real ones in the building. Don't go nowhere. That shit's still closing it. Don't go nowhere.